I need somebody help. Not just anybody help. You know I need someone help. When I was younger, so much younger than today, I never needed anybody's help in any way. Now these days are gone, I'm not so self-assured. I've changed my mind and open up the doors. Help me if you can, I'm feeling down, and I do appreciate you being round. Help me get my feet back on the ground. Won't you please, please help me?
I'm Nocerino, and I am the village historian for Norwood. Some of you guys and girls I do know. This is known as a broadside, which was one of the earliest forms of advertising. There was no TV, no radio back when it was on the wall. This is what they call a semi-lithograph. It's not a true lithograph. It was made by the Erie Lithograph Company from Pennsylvania. And we know that they made these type of lithographs from 1880 to approximately 1917, when the company went out of business. This particular one on the side of the building was for the play Uncle Tom's Cabin by Harriet Beecher Stowe. She wrote the play, I believe, in 1851, but this is post-Civil War, and the play was produced in Norwood by the DeWolf Company. You can see his name here. And it was another little poster attached to this. And it said, Christmas Day, December 25th, Norwood. We didn't know the year. So we used the Northern New York Library Network system, and we found a story in the old Potsdam Herald Reporter, where the wolf is in Potsdam, New York, with his family and his cast, and they were having the play on Christmas Eve. But the story goes on to tell you that on December 25th, they were coming by train to Norwood, and across the street was an old music hall that is long gone, and that's where the play would be held on Christmas Day. The play back then had great social significance. We're looking at it in 2009, and it has been covered for 112 years, and one of the workers, John Mullen, who was tearing the building layers down, come across this. And if you look carefully, this is segmented. It's not one piece. It's different pieces, like they do the billboards that you see them put up along the roadside. Sometimes you see the guys putting the sections up. Same principle. This here is put on top of other lithographs and posters. You can see one for the Wild West show up there where it says Sitting Bull. There's a remainder up there. But this is the largest one of its kind in New York that we know of. We're going to try to preserve this in place. The owner of the building, DJ Colbert, was very, very supportive without tearing it down and letting people stop by and see it. And we're going to try to conserve the paper, which is pretty fragile. And we put the plexiglass up, but that's really not the best. Sunlight is very dangerous for this. It will fade very quickly. The Erie Company made most of these poster size, which are familiar today, the regular size posters that you put on your wall, this is unique in its size. If you want to get closer, you can see it because back there you can't see. It's different stories, different characters out of the story Uncle Tom's Cabin. And it starts with Legree whipping Uncle Tom and it works its way down into the slave auction. But it is quite interesting for what it is, and that it survived with the colors so vibrant after 112 years. Did you guys in the back see this? These pictures up front?
They're flares, so I think what we'll do is, I would like to walk down that and actually walk by it, because all I can see is...
You're looking at one section of the story. Down here is a whole nother section of the story. The lithograph, this lithograph here was made 1897, probably in the summer, but it was put up in December on the wood side of the building. And that's just another you know, oddity that would survive the winter months.